Hello, I'm Owen Corso from Google, and in this video we'll cover how to hand code an ad in HTML5 that will be uploaded to AdWords. You can learn how to upload to AdWords in a separate video. The ad we'll build includes headline text and logo, an action button, styling, which is the fonts and the colors, and animation. To get started, you can download the files we'll be working with at this Google short link. The zip file is a fully pre-configured template for AdWords. If you were to upload it into AdWords right now, it could be used as an ad, but I wouldn't recommend it. The ad would be empty. HTML includes three core constituents: the skeleton or structure, which is an HTML file comprised of markup; the skin or presentation layer, which is the CSS; and then the brain or the behavior, which is the JavaScript. The index.html file is the root of your HTML5 ad and is what pulls all the other pieces together. Inside the index.html file, you'll see two pieces, the head section and the body section. The head section includes all of your references to other pieces of your creative. Think of it as the section that tells AdWords how to build and show your ad. With the head section, you can do the following: define the size of your ad, define your CSS files and fonts to include, define the JavaScript files to include, determine the ad click behavior. The ad size meta tag defines the height and width of your ad. It is what AdWords uses to determine which inventory your ad is suitable for. Change the height and width values in the meta tag to match the ad size you want to build for. In this tutorial, we're using width equals 300 and height equals 250. This code defines the CSS and font files that our ad needs to render properly. Let's see what each line does. Line 1, the Google recommended CSS line, tells AdWords to include Google recommended CSS file that's also included in the zip folder. The CSS file is meant to normalize how each browser behaves when it sees HTML content. For instance, by picking a standard font or padding for each element. Line 2, the style.css line, tells AdWords to include the style.css file that's also included in the zip folder. The CSS file should include all of the styling rules that apply for your ad. Note, you can have as many of these CSS files as you wish, but for the purpose of this ad, we'll just have one. This line tells AdWords to fetch a Google font, but this won't actually make the ad use it. First, we need to add Google's font name, Roboto Slab, to the styles.css file. You can use any Google font by switching the font family name in the URL string. Browse for other Google fonts to include in your ad. Use script tags to define the JavaScript files that should be included in your ad. Scripts enable interactivity and animation for your creative, making the ad come alive for your customers. We've included ad-interactivity.js as the script that will hold all of our other interactivity code. This script is a file inside of our zip folder that we will fill out later. And you can add as many script files as you'd like as long as they're included in your ad zip file, but the total size of all of your files need to be below 150 kilobytes. The last thing the head section does is define how your customers will leave your ad and go to your landing page. There are two ways customers can click out of your ad. The first way is to navigate to your landing page by clicking anywhere on the whole ad, which is done automatically, so no extra code is required. The second way to exit is by clicking on an individual element and including the exit API script in the head section and running some of that on user click. The exit API script adds the necessary JavaScript code for supporting custom behavior to exit. Later in this tutorial, we'll see how to use the exit API script. The body section of the index.html file is where the actual content of our ad is stored. As you can see, the body section includes a header section, an image tag for a logo, a button tag for a call to action. The style.css and the Google recommended styles.css files determine how the content should look. The Google recommended styles host rules that make sure each browser has a consistent set of rules. We recommend that you keep the CSS file for all your projects, but it is not required. The CSS file is for the specific style sheet for this creative, and it includes all of the rules that make your ad look like our ad. And think of it as a coat of paint that's applied to the top of the content in the HTML file. The addInteractivity.js file defines how the content in the HTML file interacts with the customer. Will it animate? What will happen when a user clicks our button? These are answered by the JavaScript defined in our ad. Note that all of the images we want to include in our ad must be included in the zip. We call these local files because they're included inside the ad as opposed to external files, which are located outside of the ad file. External files are not allowed for HTML5 ads in AdWords unless they are a Google font or a Google-hosted version of jQuery. Now that you have all of the pieces of the ad, you can start building the content with the index.html file with this code. Open the index.html file in a browser window to preview your ad. It should look something like this. Now open the addInteractivity.js file in any editor and paste this code. This JavaScript does three things. First, it calls an anonymous function on pageLoad. Second, in that function, we save a reference to our call to action button in a local variable. Then third, we add a listener to that call to action button that calls our exit API.exit script on click. The exit API.exit function tells AdWords to leave your ad and go to the landing page. You can call this function only via click-based events, things like button clicks, anchor clicks, etc. Otherwise, AdWords will ignore it. Now that you've added content to your ad, you can add some style to it using CSS. To preview your ad, you should restrict its size dimensions to 300 pixels wide by 200 pixels high. If anything is outside of this 300 by 250 box, it won't show. Keeping the ad within these dimensions will make it easier to view as your users will see it. Use the following CSS code to give the ad its basic style. Remember how we added the Roboto slab font in the head section of our ad? Well, it's not yet formatting anything yet. We'll have to tell the ad to use it on all of our elements, like this. Next, we're going to format the header's background and make sure the header text is white. Because the logo is too big in the ad, it needs to be smaller and centered between the header and the bottom of the colored bar, like this. The last part we need to format is the call to action button. As you saw in the mock above, it's way too small and improperly placed. We'll have to expand its padding, change up its color, and position it in the ad, like this. Well, now the ad looks good, but it's still an image ad. Let's animate. Animations can be achieved in several ways, such as using a Google-hosted third-party library like jQuery, or natively using JavaScript and CSS. CSS transitions can animate between two different states. For example, we want the headline and learn more button to fade in and slide up from the bottom. For the headline, copy this CSS into the style.css file. Similarly, for the Learn More button, copy this CSS into the style sheet as well. Now your ad should look like this. We're ready to upload our ad, so let's compress the file so AdWords can accept the upload. You can upload your HTML5 zip file the same way you uploaded any other image ad. And great, now you're done.